Alright, so I haven't shot any videos really this year at all. I did a bit of walk around on this video, or this trailer we bought. And one thing you'll notice really quick, if I go straight back, the tongue's not straight. It shows up on the camera really well. So I finally got this home. It's got some new-ish tires on it. And I've got just miscellaneous work stuff. And then just kind of the debris field of operations, I guess. I don't know. So this is the World War II MC5 bomb trailer. Now, there's normally a big, you can Google it, but there's a big caster that goes up here. So this thing's been modified. It's not an original trailer. It's got some damage to it. I started off with that data plate in the beginning. It's got a, 5,000 pound payload as original. So what I started doing here is I started knocking, there's some clamps that were on this stuff. And started knocking these out. There's just no way, this is going to get pulled apart. I mean, some of that wiring's in good shape. But I mean, this wiring is just cooked. So it's kind of interesting how they got this trailer got electric brakes and manual brakes. You see this rod driven down the rod. Anyway, so, but you can see they used almost like a Romex connector down to a, just another electrical connector to route the wiring for the brakes rather than going through the axle shaft as like is on a lot of modern trailers. So this thing runs on 750/20s. Obviously we got it on there, get the thing off. It looks like the center cap actually threads off because it's got looks like actually 8 sizes, 2, 4, 6, 8. Sorry about that. 3-piece split rim or lockering wheel. Another interesting thing is they could daisy chain these trailers together, so the old plug is still there. Lights are toast. And obviously the other hitch is gone, or their pinel. So real interesting trailer. I overall bought it just as, basically just to use. I'm gonna put a deck on it. You can see this wiring's just cooked. Where did I see? I think there's a part up here that's pretty well, some of it's pretty well preserved, but you can just see a close-up detail of the, there we go, that steel coating that was on it. But pretty much the goal for this trailer is it's just gonna be a flat trailer that we can use for business, moving the trenchers around. Nothing, kind of general purpose, nothing real heavy duty. It's got a 5,000 pound capacity, which is a lot better than what I've had in the past. Definitely a sweat equity trailer, but I thought with the history and everything else, the opportunity, I was like, yeah, I'm gonna do it. So it's kind of a mutt. I'm in town for a couple days and I've got to leave again. You can see it almost looks like a tree or something fell across it. So I've got, it looks like it really just messed up that outer kind of frame for this looks like it had maybe this later on this trailer had sides on it or something. But, the toolbox will probably go because it's rotted out. I got to fix the tongue. I got to figure out if the tongue, because there's going to be a weak point about, I'm not saying there's probably a weak point about here between the old frame and this tongue that I don't think is going to be strong enough. But, my goal is I want to get this paint, I want to get sandblast, I want to get cleaned up so we can use it. I think the leaf springs are saleable, minus the hardware. Drum brakes need to be repacked, got electric brakes on it. So I just want to give a quick overview and kind of document some of it, but just kind of give you a walk around before we get too far into this. I really don't know how, how this is all going to go. But I'm just trying to just strip some stuff that's in my way right now and kind of get it so I can start figuring out what I'm gonna do. So that's all I got.